Hello friends, I'm Mr. Bhali Rao sir and I welcome you to my channel that is English for Learners. Friends, today we are going to learn one of the best motivational topic and that is His First Flight written by Liam O'Flaherty. Before watching this video, as usual I request you don't forget to subscribe my channel. First of all, let's see the summary of the topic His First Flight. This is a story about the painful process of learning an important lesson in life. The main character of this story is a baby seagull which has to learn to fly. For most of the birds, learning to fly is taken for granted, but we seldom think the mental agony which the bird may have to go through while doing so. This short story beautifully depicts the situation. The parents and siblings of the baby seagull apply all the tricks to cajole and force it to fly. Finally, the baby seagull succeeds in overcoming its fear and learns to fly. Characters of the stories are 1. A baby seagull is there. 2. His two brothers and one more, his younger sister is there, as well as baby seagull's parents, mother and father. Let's see the explanation of this story in detail or line by line. The young seagull was alone on his ledge. Ledge means a narrow horizontal shelf projecting from a wall, as you can see in the picture. The picture of ledge. And there, this young or small seagull was alonely sitting there. His two brothers and his sister had already flown away the day before. He had been afraid to fly with them. The seagull did not go with his family because he had been afraid to fly with them. Somehow, when he had taken a little run forward to the brink of the ledge and attempted to flap his wings, he became afraid. Once he tried to run and to fly forward to brink. Brink means the edge of a steep place, but he could not fly. And attempted means he tried to flap his wings. Flapping wings, as you know that, he became afraid. Means that baby seagull tried to fly by flapping his wings but could not fly because he was afraid a lot. The great expanse of sea stretched down beneath. Before the edge or the ledge or that brink, there was a great stretched sea down beneath, and it was such a long way down, miles down. He felt certain that his wings would never support him. This baby seagull is afraid a lot because he felt that his wings would never support him. So he bent his head and ran away back the little hole under the ledge where he slept at night. So that day he tried to fly, but because of fearful nature he did not get success, and at last he ran away back to the little hole under the ledge where he slept at night. Even when each of his brothers and his little sister, whose wings were far shorter than his own, ran to the brink, flapped their wings and flew away, he failed to muster up courage to take that plunge which appeared to him so desperate. So in this line, the writer says that the little seagull's brothers and sister, though their wings were a little shorter than the seagull, but they were able to fly. And only because of fearful nature or afraid, he was not able to fly. And he failed to muster up the courage. This baby seagull failed to muster up courage means to gather courage. He did not have a courage to take that plunge, to take that flight which appeared to him so desperate. So he desperately liked to fly, but only not having the courage, he was unsuccessful. He was failing. And that time his father and mother had come around calling to him shrilly, upbraiding him, threatening to let him starve on his ledge unless he flew away. So in these lines, his parents try to saying shrilly means with a loud sound. Upbraiding means sometimes they were scolding him, threatening him. What they were telling to the baby seagull, they were telling, saying, you will be starved, you will be get hungry on this ledge if you do not try to fly away. But for the life of him, he could not. So because of fearful nature, that seagull could not move, could not try to fly. So this is the explanation of the first paragraph. That was 24 hours ago. Since then, nobody had come near him. Now he was alone there on his ledge. And already 24 hours were passed. The day before, all day long, he had watched his parents flying about with his brothers and sister, perfecting them in the art of flight. So he watched how his parents were teaching his brothers and sister for how perfectly fly in the sky, teaching them how to skim. Skim means move or go lightly just above a surface here on the sea. So his parents were teaching to his brothers how to fly, skim the waves, and how to dive for fish. How to dive for fish, how to take dive for catching the fish. So they were teaching them. He had in fact seen his older brother catch his first herring and devour it. The eagle saw his older brother how he caught herring. Herring is one of the fish, and devour means how his brother was eating hungrily, standing on a rock. While his parents circled around raising a proud cackle, his brother was eating that fish and his parents were praising him. And all that scene, situation that seagull was watching. And all the morning, the whole family had walked about on the big plateau midway down the opposite cliff. Cliff means high steep face of a rock, taunting him for his cowardice. So that morning, his parents, his family, whole family walked away on that big plateau, and they were teasing him. Taunting means teasing. From that cliff, from that rock, they were teasing him how he was coward, discouraged. The sun was now ascending the sky, blazing on his ledge that faced the south. So there was a sunbeams of sunlight, a hot sunlight blazing on his ledge that faced the south. He felt the heat because he had not eaten since the previous nightfall. So since last 24 hours he was hungry, and due to that blazing sun he felt that heat. He stepped slowly out to the brink of the ledge, and standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wing, so he tried to walk out of that brink of the ledge, hiding one leg in a wing and standing on one leg. He tried to close one eye and then the other, and he was pretending to be falling asleep. So that way he was standing there. Still they took no notice of them. He tried to show his family. He was trying to showing his family that he was asleep on one leg, but nobody from his family noticing him or pay attention to him. He saw his two brothers and his sister lying on the plateau, dozing with their heads sunk into their neck. And he saw his brothers and sister were dozing. Dozing means sleeping by hiding a head into their necks. And that time his father was preening. Preening means making an effort to clean feathers with beak, preening the feathers on his white back. The father's activity was going on there. Only his mother was looking at him. His mother was watching him. She was standing on a little high hump. Hump means a round raised mass on land, a high place on that plateau. Her white breast thrust forward. She moved forward now and again. She tore at a piece of fish that lay at her feet, and then scraped each side of her beak on the rock. So actually that seagull was so much hungry, and before him his mother was eating tearing a piece of fish, but she was not giving to him. So that was the scene, and she was scraping, scrap means rubbing her beak on that rock for sharpness. The sight of the food maddened him when that seagull saw that fish which his mother has held, and he became so curious, hungry for that food. How he loved to tear food that way. He was also imagining he wanted to tear that food, that fish, in this way. Scraping his beak now, he wanted to scraping his beak like his mother, and again to wet it. Wet it means to make it sharpen. Ga ga, he cried, begging her to bring him some food. So by making some sound like a gaga, he cried, begging, he was requesting his mother for giving him some food, that fish. And what was the reply of his mother? Go call gha, she screamed back derisively. Derisively means in a manner showing someone that he is stupid. So she replied by screaming or making sound that seagull is stupid. But he kept calling plaintively. He was requesting, he was begging his mother plaintively. Plaintively means expressing sorrow. And after a minute or so, he uttered a joyful scream. He became a happy and he started screaming. His mother had picked up a piece of the fish and was flying across to him with it. Why he was become so happy? Why was he was screaming joyfully? Because his mother had picked up a piece of that fish and was flying towards him. He leaned out eagerly. He moved out eagerly, curiously, tapping the rock with his feet and trying to get nearer to her as she flew across. And seagull felt that his mother is giving that piece of fish to him. But when she was just opposite to him, she halted. She stopped there. She cannot come nearer. Her wings motionless. The piece of fish in her beak almost within reach of his beak. So there was a piece of fish in his mother's beak, and it was that much nearer. It was so close to that seagull, but she was not giving him. He waited a moment in surprise, and he became surprised, wondering why she did not come nearer. And then, maddened by hunger, he was so hungry, he wanted to eat that piece of fish. He was mad with hunger. And for that piece of fish, he dived at the fish. He jumped towards the fish. With a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards into space. Now, he was in the space, and he fell outwards and downwards into that space. Then a monstrous terror, monstrous and shocking, it was shocking for him, the first time he was in the space, and terror seized him. Terror means he became so afraid and his heart stood still. He could hear nothing because he was alone in that space. But it only lasted a minute. Only lasted a minute. For some time he was afraid of it. But after that, the next moment, he felt his wings spread outwards. Means now he spread his wings for flying. The wind rushed against his breast feathers. Now he was feeling the wind. Then under his stomach and against his wings, he could feel the tips of his wings cutting through the air. Now he was flying and he was feeling how he was moving forward in the space through this wind air. He was not falling headlong now. He was soaring gradually downwards and outwards. And with confidently, first time in his life, that seagull was soaring. Soaring means flying slowly, gradually, slowly downwards and outwards. He was no longer afraid. He was no longer afraid means he was not in a fearful mood. He have a lot of confidence, courage. He just felt a bit dizzy. Dizzy means just uncomfortable for some time. Then he flapped his wings once and he soared upward. Ga, 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 ga. Ga, 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 la. His mother swooped past him. His mother was also watching. She was also flying around him, her wings making a loud noise. He answered her with another scream. Then his father flew over him, screaming. So in this way, when that small baby seagull was first time flying in the space, and that time his mother and father, they were also flying around him and encouraging him. He saw his two brothers and his sister flying around him, curvetting and banking and soaring and dying. Curvetting means leaping like a horse. Leaping, jumping, flying. This is a way of flying. And banking means flying with one wing higher than the other. So in this way, very happily, joyfully, his brothers and sisters also flying around him, soaring and diving. Then he completely forgot that he had not always been able to fly. And when he was flying, that time he forget. Once he was not able to fly, he forgot all that things. And commended himself. Commended means he was praising himself. To dive and soar and curve, shrieking shrilly. Shrieking means making a loud cry, shrilly. So with a joyfully, he was making a sound because first time he was flying. He was near the sea now, flying straight over it, facing straight out over the ocean. Now that seagull was flying over the ocean, over the sea. He saw a vast green sea beneath him. Under or below him, there was a vast spreaded sea. And color of the water seems to be green, with a little ridge moving over it. Ridge means a chain of hills. Around that sea, some mountain or hilly area was there. And over that sea he was flying. And he turned his beak sideways and cawed amusedly. So, by turning his beak sideways with a pleasurably, amusedly means pleasurably, he turned his beak toward the hills. So, in this way, that seagull was flying over the sea. His parents and his brothers and sister had landed on this green flooring ahead of him. So ahead of him, brothers and sister, they halted, stopped over that green water. And main thing was that seagull did not know how to land on the sea water. They were beckoning to him. Beckoning means his brothers and sisters were calling him. The meaning of beckoning is to give a signal to come nearer or to follow them. He dropped his legs to stand on the green sea. First time he tried to drop or stand on that green sea, on this water. But what happened? His legs sank into it, and surprisingly, his legs went inside the water. He screamed with fright and he became so afraid because his legs were sank inside and attempted to rise again. Actually, he was so hungry, he became weak due to the hunger, and he tried to rise again. Rise means to fly again over the sea and flapping his wings, but he was tired and weak with hunger and could not rise. Exhausted by the strange exercise. So first time he flew in the space, first time he had by flapping the wings, he became exhausted, like it was a surprise or strange like an exercise, and his feet sank into the green sea. And then his belly touched the water, and he sank no further. So he could not drown that into the water. He was floating on it. And it was surprising for him. And around him, his family was screaming, praising him. They were praising, and their beaks were offering him scrap of dogfish. And when he was succeeded in flying and floating, and that time his family has given their beaks, were offering him, giving him the scraps of dogfish food, and he had made his first flight successfully. So friends, I hope you might have liked this video. If you liked it, please share it. If you have any suggestions for me, please write in comment box. Wish you good day. Thank you very much.